Shout out to Luis Animation. This is a remake of his method with B-bones.
Link for Luis's tutorial is in the description.
Hide the rig and unhide the root armature. Go to edit mode and hide the lip bones and face bones. Do the same in the pose mode. Bring the 3D cursor here. Make a new bone and adjust its length. Extrude one big and one small bone. Activate wireframe shading.
Select and move the bones in Y axis.
Let's rename the bones.
Hip upper.l, hip.l, hip lower.l.
Select the hip upper bone and clear it of its parent. Go to pose mode. Select the hip bone and add a switch to constraint. Set the root armature as the target and set the hip upper as the target bone. Check volume, min and max. Okay, now the middle bone stretches and follows the upper bone. In data properties tab, choose display as B bone. Select all bones and scale up a little. Scale up the new helper bones even more to distinguish them from the rest. Increase bendy bone segments. Set tangent for start and end handles. Set X, Z and ease for scale. Set hip lower for start custom and hip upper for end custom. Go to edit mode, parent hip lower to thigh with keep offset and parent hip upper to spine 01. Uncheck deform for upper and lower bones. Okay, bendy bone is working. If you ever need to resize the bendy bone set, make sure to select tail of middle bone together with the upper bone. After resizing, reset its original length in pose mode.
Now let's duplicate these bones. Move them here, then rotate and resize by changing position.
Let's name these bones torso. Duplicate and arrange bendy bones once again and name them armpit. Duplicate one more time and arrange like this. Let's also arrange the bones from side view. Let's name these bones shoulder.
Let's link each upper and lower end bones. Torso lower to spine 01. Torso upper to spine 05. Armpit upper to clavicle. Armpit lower to upper arm. Shoulder lower to upper arm. Shoulder upper to clavicle. Let me hide the bone names.
Go to pose mode and reset original lengths of bendy bones. Let's test how our helper bones help with skinning. Select the short and jeans and parent them to root armature with automatic weights. Not bad. Select all of the new bone sets and go to bone collections. Remove the bones from whatever collections they are in and put them in a new collection. While selected, go to armature and then symmetrize. Set the 3D cursor between these bones and make a new bone. Resize and scale up the bone. Let's name it hip center. Add an armature constraint to the bone. Add three target bones. Here we need to define the armature and here individual bones.
Each left and right hip bone will have half of impact on the center hip bone.
Now if you want to use these bones in Rigify, then let's assign basic supercopy rig type to each green deformation bone.
Unfortunately, Rigify doesn't support the bendy bones. I hope one day bendy bones will be supported.
Let me leave this bone as it is to show the difference. Now let's regenerate rig. Select meshes, duplicate and join. Let's rename it. Delete vertex groups. Remove modifiers and materials. Add a remesh modifier. Increase voxel size and apply the modifier. While mesh is selected, shift select the rig and parent with automatic weights.
Select unified mesh and hide it for now. Unhide and select the jeans and the short meshes, then shift select the rig and parent with empty groups. Unhide and select the unified mesh, then select the jeans mesh, then go to weight paint. Now go to weights, then transfer weights. For source layers, select by name. Go to object node. Once more select the unified mesh, then select the short mesh, then repeat the previous procedure. Hide the unified mesh. Let's see how helper bones work. Activate mirroring. Helper bones do a great job, considering they are dealing with a rather high poly mesh. Notice how right and left shoulders behave differently. Let me unhide the head together with eyes, teeth, hair, etc. Let's quickly connect hands and shoes to the rig with automatic weights. If you are new to my channel, please check out the previous tutorials. Okay, fingers are working fine. Face bones are also good. See you in another tutorial.